Vanakkam, this is Haider Ali Sayyed from Asivagam, united under Tamil Shiva.
Also, but basically the mindset of people has somehow convinced them to believe in what others say rather than what is in the textbook. I mean, whatever the books any person is following. Everybody is lazy enough not to look into the book and, you know, actually understand what is there, what is written, what does it mean, what's the perspective and all. So, I don't know. I just want to know if there is any sort of wisdom given in Quran about this, regarding this.
Quran is a reminder. It reminds previous people the book. It's a Furqan, correcting the previous book, reminding the previous people, the book, people of the book, and the children of Israel. So it's basically, Quran is a reminder. It's not a book of conversion. So those people who have used Quran as a religious book, they have no rights to do that, because Prophet Muhammad never started any new religion. He just reminded everyone. You can open chapter 42 verse 13 to find out what Prophet Muhammad was. He's a follower. He's not a founder. You're getting the point? Prophet Muhammad is a follower. Not a founder. So what he followed,
can you repeat the number please?
Chapter 42 verse 13, it clearly says that Prophet Muhammad followed the same part which Noah had followed, and the same part was followed by Ibrahim, Moses and Jesus, and don't get divided into it. So and Prophet Noah followed which way of life? Followed the first Siddha, or first administrator part, that is the set or Shiva part, and Quran says straight, guide us to the straight part. What is that straight part? Straight part is very simple. It's a God guided part, which is called Asivagam in Tamil.
Okay.
Yeah.
And I always was curious about this part. How was the Quran written? Maybe I have not done enough homework to know the exact, you know, understanding of it. Can you please
elaborate? Scribe is a profession that was there right from the beginning. Scribe, the people,
scribe.
Scribe. The people who used to write scribes, S-C-R-I-B-E, scribes. It's a profession. And when, as among the children of Israel and people of the book, prophet used to come and they used to write it down. All the everything was written down immediately.
Okay, but. No, actually, scribe. Scribe means a person who copies or documents.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah. It's a profession in every time. Their role is just to follow the kings or the prophets, and they write it down. That's their job.
And okay, and where did they copy the data, the information?
Chapter 96:1-5, thought by pen.
96:1-5,
chapter 96 verse 1-5. Yeah, it's very clear that Allah thought by pen, means written form of language was given, and to the first Siddha, that is Shiva, and all the information on all subjects was thought to third son of Adam, that is Shiva, and then he taught everyone, each children of Adam, different professions or caste.
Sorry to interrupt you. I'm not actually getting the. Is it
96?
96.
First five verses.
One to five
verses.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. So.
Yeah, so it says, created from cling, the Lord who in the name of your Lord who created, created humans from. Clinging clot, read, and your Lord is most generous, who taught by pen, taught humanity what they knew not.
Yeah.
Most certainly, one exceeds all bound.
So all the information on all subjects was given to first Siddha, and that's the reason why Quran chapter 6:6 clearly says that the previous generation is far more superior to this current generation. You can read chapter 6:6.
Six. Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
It says they have not seen how many disbelieving people we have destroyed before them. We had made them more established in the land than you. We sent down an abundant rain for them and made rivers to flow at their feet. Then we destroyed them for their sins and replaced them with other people.
Yeah, so this first half of the of this ayat is talking about the first Sangam, that is first Tamil Sangha, that is the Pandyan Sangha. And pyramids across the globe were colonies of Pandyans, and all the pyramids are before the deluge, not after the deluge. And after the deluge, the the civilization, the information was reduced, and we lost lots of technology, and that's the reason why Shiva is considered as alien, because they cannot come close to the information which Shiva had. That's the reason why Sadhguru and the Europeans are saying that Shiva is an alien. They don't want to say that he got all the information from God. So that's the reason why he is considered as alien. And even Switzerland, CERN laboratory, you will find Shiva Nataraj statue over there.
I'm not clear about the part where, I heard that it was translated from sound. Inside the cave, there was a echo from Jibril alayhi salam, and he would say out.
Yeah, that's Prophet Muhammad is not the first messenger to receive revelation.
They loud, and then they will write. Is that the right format? Am I right? Or?
Yeah, you see, whatever. Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Prophet Muhammad, when he first got the message, he was afraid and he went back. Then he declared that he is getting revelation, and people came near him. And
After. Quran was revealed whenever he went inside the cave.
No, not that way. It could come anytime. As per the situation, because there is a situation where Prophet waited for the revelation to come to give answer. Because Quran is very clear that.
Yes.
So
yes,
right, there is no thing that he will have to go to the cave, and cave is the transmitter or something like that. No, it's a God is not.
Okay, the last specific pages were revealed on a specific month, which we term as Ramadan, right? Is that right?
No. The thing is, what came first, I don't want to go into that, because the final fight is Surah Tawbah. Where Prophet Muhammad gave the declaration to Roman Empire, Persian Empire, and after that they got defeated, and after that those people were not allowed to enter into Hijaz region. You can read chapter 9 verse 28 or 29. Yeah. So after Fateh Makkah, they were not allowed to enter into Mecca and Medina. They means referring to the white people.
No, my question is actually the way Quran has been how was it written? Just wanted to be
the scribes were there. The scribes were there, no? Scribes.
Okay, scribes. From where did they get the data? Like
which data?
Okay, so Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam would speak out, and they will write.
Yeah. They will write. They will write, and people Sangha era, Sangam, get together. When there is a prophet, the people used to surround him, and they used to sit with him only. There were people, chief of the clan used to sit with them, those who were loyal to him. So the people used to write it down, and they used to note it out everything. And and Prophet Muhammad is the last messenger, and there were many messengers that came, and they were writing books, and that's the reason why you find lots of books, means the pages in caves in Jordan, and all those people are finding it. You're getting the point. So they had the habit of writing it down. Because
so there has to be someone present all the time.
Right? It's a situation where people used to, there was a certain rank assigned for writing down. That's why there is a verse in Quran, when you have a transaction, call for the scribe and write it down.
Okay. And I don't know. I heard something like this, that there was more than. It's like a filtration process. There is more than one person. One would write, and another would write, and they would compare with each other.
No.
What has been?
No, that's No, that's everything was written down immediately, and then God has preserved that book for with Himself. And one more thing, like you want to catch this Muslim world lie, see the right to administration, is it with Ali, Umar, Siddiq, or with someone else?
I don't know.
See, the thing is, right to administration was with the Shiva, the Pandya colony, and after the Mahabharata and all that, and Aryans came into Iranian plateau, and then Ibrahim got training around 2500 years back, BC. Ibrahim came in picture, and he was trained, and then he was the covenant between God and Ibrahim took place, and the circumcision is a part of that covenant, and family of Ibrahim should do the covenant. Okay, I mean circumcision.
What is this?
I mean, the prophet came up in his lineage. The ayat says it in Quran. Okay. I will make the imam in my nation. So imam means leaders. The leaders will be appointed. Prophet will be appointed. But Quran is very clear that only those who are loyal, those who are humble, they will get that my covenant is with them. That's the reason why Quran, Surah Baqarah, ayat number 40 is talking now, that O children of Israel, fulfill your covenant, I will fulfill my covenant. It's written there, no?
Okay.
So the covenant is there, and Ibrahim took the first covenant, and circumcision was the part of that agreement, and other people are not supposed to do circumcision, because if they do circumcision, they are going against Quran chapter 95 verse 4.
Circumcision is a sunnah, this thing, right?
Chapter 95 verse 4, right? Note it down. It means you can read it. 95.4.
Created humans from the best form. We have certainly created man in the best of stature.
Yeah, mold. Yeah, best of mold. So Adam was created from the black clay, and then he was put into a mold, and then fashioned him in a proportion. That's what Quran is telling. Best of mold.
So circumcision is not required.
Circumcision is not a part of Islam. It's only a covenant between Ibrahim and God. A part of covenant, and whoever is from bloodline of Ibrahim, they are supposed to do it. If you and me are from bloodline, we have to do it. But since we are following circumcision makes us Muslim, so everyone is doing. You're getting the point.
Okay.
Quran is not a book of conversion. Quran is not a reminder, not a book of conversion, because you can read chapter 36 verse 1 to 12. It clearly stops Prophet Muhammad from wasting his time on the cursed, heedless people whose forefathers were not warned. So Prophet Muhammad never converted anyone. You can read Yasin from 1 to 12.
One second. Please tell me the number.
36.
Yasin. Okay. Yasin. Okay. So.
But before that, remember that. Prior to Prophet Muhammad, all prophets were meant for their certain people. But Prophet Muhammad is a universal messenger. So he's also a messenger for a people whose forefathers were not, referring to the bloodline of Cain, the first Antichrist, the Romans and the Persians. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And Allah is stopping them. Whether you want them or do not want them, they will not believe. Forget them. So, and since the Quran is a reminder, verse 12 says it's a reminder. Reminder means what? People who already have the documentation, this Quran is reminding them. People who have no books or messenger, for them, this Quran is not a reminder. You hope you got the point.
For them, can they follow?
No, but you're getting the point. See, Quran.
Yeah, I got the point.
Your point, huh? Because suppose you are having a deal with somebody, and you have sent you want the money. You send the letter, and this is the final letter. Or I will go to the court.
No, don't confuse. I got the point.
You got the point.
But my question is that if there is, like, for example. If someone is an atheist who does not believe in
God, there is no such thing as God atheist. See, even if he's atheist, God will judge him as per he's the owner of Judgment Day. I am not, so we cannot say whether it is atheist or something like that. But as far as where Quran is concerned, Quran is not concerned with any of the Shia, Sufi, Sunni, Wahhabi, or Muslim world, because Muslim world has no from bloodline. They are all children of Cain. I mean, Persian Empire, Roman Empire. Shia, the Persian became Shia today, the Sunni became Romans, and the Ottomans are the Sufis, And the last and final beast, that is Satan Saudi, where Hadith talks about devil from Najd. The Saudi has is funding the Wahhabi organization. So these are all anti-Christ army. Yeah, so they are not part of Islam. They are outside the fold of Islam. And this is the reason why there are 2 billion plus Muslim and not one single Muslim knows Quran. Because Quran, the basic purpose of Quran was to remind, unite and fight against the Roman Empire, Persian Empire. So the people who are from those bloodline, they will not, they will see to that, that Quranic message doesn't reach the concerned person. So that's the reason why they started a Shia organization, Sunni organization, Sufi, Wahhabi. And when you see, Shia destroyed the language of Quran, that is Arabic, and promoted Urdu and Farsi. Then we have Sunni, where Piri Muridi system was involved, Sufism and all that. And then we have Tabligh Jamaat, who are just propagating Fazail-e Amal and other book. And then we have this Wahhabi organization, who are terrorist organization. They are just funding, means promoting evil. In the name of Hadith, they are bringing all those kachras into the society. You're getting the point?
Yeah.
So, Quran, Prophet Muhammad never reminded. And plus, you can read chapter 2, verse 120.
Chapter 2, 120.
Yeah.
Surah Al-Baqarah. Never will the Jews or the Christian be pleased with you until you follow their faith. Say Allah is guidance and they are true guidance. If you were to follow their desires, after all the knowledge has come to you, there would be none to protect you or help you against Allah.
Yeah.
Okay.
So the Jew refers to the Persian and the Christian refers to Romans. So the Romans and the Persian will never be satisfied with you. You refers to children of Israel and people of the book until you follow their way of life. Means they will be pushing you to convert, and if you convert after the knowledge has come to you, you will not get any helper or protector. This is what is telling.
Okay. But okay, now if all the previous books like Bible, Torah, whether you know God's word or
yeah, there's a God's word.
Then why is it like it's completely do not follow that specific thing? Why is that so?
Nowhere it says that don't follow it, because Quran is a reminder, and chapter 3 verse 3 clearly says na, Quran is here to confirm those book. You can read it, chapter 3 verse 3.
He sends down to you book in parts, the truth confirming. Divine, or the truths will be contained in Revelation prior to it, and he sent to Torah and all.
So nowhere Quran says that. And Quran is a Furqan. Furqan means judging between right and wrong. So if you want to look into the previous book, Quran, you have to go use Quran as a measurement to check the previous book.
Oh, fine. Okay, so it's like the relative. That's a relative term which you would.
So Quran, the Bible, after the coming of Quran, all books are okay, provided you look everything from Quran. You got the point?
Point of view, with reference to Quran.
With reference to Quran. That's why Quran is confirming it. Quran does it, and Quran is a reminder. Quran is a Furqan. Furqan means judging between right and wrong. So this book is a criteria for the previous book to be judged. Means we have to use Quran to judge the previous book.
So how pure is that? I mean, has that been contaminated kind of thing, right?
Previous book, na? Yeah, it has been corrupted. And corrupted means inserted. It means concept has been changed. Like for example, in India, we have two Shiva. The North India Shiva and the South India Shiva. Similarly, we have two Jesus, the black Jesus and the white Jesus. We have two Muhammad, one white and one black. So all this is there. So when you read Quran, you will get all your answer into it.
That's quite interesting. You made me quite interested in getting a proper useful hobby, I would say.
Yeah.
Thank you.
And one more, I just check chapter 49, verse 13. You will understand how deceptive these Muslims are.
49:13:13. Okay, Quran, Hujurat. O mankind, we have created you from male and female and made you into races and tribes so that you might identify one another. Surely the noblest of you in Allah's sight is the one who is highest of you. What does it mean?
Taqwa means taqwa, God fearing. The point I'm going to point over here is race and tribe. They are talking about race and tribe, na?
Race and tribe.
But the word in Arabic is shoba, and shoba is not race and tribe. Shoba means department, rank.
Okay, what does it mean?
Rank, department, caste, and oh, okay. Tribe means gotram.
Okay.
So when you are putting race, you are changing the whole interpretation of the Quran. This verse is telling that
department is like shoba. Like what? Give me an example.
Shoba of different profession.
So it's like basically caste system.
Yeah, it's a caste system. There are two type of caste system. Uh-huh. One, as per the caste system, where Khalifa gives all the caste people equal rights. And there is a caste system which doesn't give equal rights. This is the main fight. You're getting the point.
So the right way is to treat everybody equally.
First, this ayat is talking about Adam and his children. Okay. And you just read it. The first line is people. It doesn't say mankind. When mankind is used, Cain bloodline is also included. Cain is also included. But here it's talking about people. So people refers to
who is Cain?
Cain is the first son of Adam who committed the first murder. Chapter 5, verse 27. Okay. Chapter 5, verse 27. So
one second.
Yeah, just check. Just 5, verse 27.
Yeah, you continue.
Yeah. So the verse is people. So from single male and female. So common ancestry is talking about common ancestry, and from among the children of Adam, God has given them. Shoba means a caste, and from caste we have gotram or tribe. So mother colony is like ant. We have seen ant colony. Queen is there, then workers are there, then warriors are there, then internal workers are there. All those shoba is there, department is there. Okay, and then the right to administration and the first administrator and the first pandian or siddha, as per Quran chapter 2 verse 30, Shiva has been prophesied before the creation of Adam. Just check chapter 2 verse 30.
2 verse 30.
Yeah,
30. Yes. So and remember, as your Lord said to the angels, surely I am making in the earth a successor. They said, will you make therein one who will corrupt in it and shed blood?
So here we have to, the other thing is, vicegerent successful authority. Who is the first vicegerent successful authority? It's Shiva, as per the Tamil tradition. And as per the Bible, it is third son of Adam, Set. Set holds the rank of administration. And from Set bloodline, we have Noah. So when you read chapter 3 verse 33-34, you will come to know Adam, Noah, family of Imran, family of Ibrahim, descendant of each other, and this is the thing. So the right to administration, the Khalifa, the first Khalifa is Shiva and his bloodline. And the other Shoba is there so that you may know each other. So whenever there is an increase in population in every Shoba, new colonies were created. You're getting the point. All the
subcaste.
When the population increased in every caste, then they used to like how ant colony with every ranks makes another colony. Similarly, this was another colony was made. So wherever you find pyramids across the globe, they are all Pandyan colonies before the deluge.
Oh. And you actually told me this ayat in which the Shiva's name is mentioned. Can you just once again?
Shiva is actually talking about the five god during the time of Noah. Sowa, S U WA, Sowa. I'm not recollecting the verse number, but the five okay. names are mentioned. So it's basically, chapter 3, verse 33. Open it.
Surely Allah has elected Adam and Noah in the house of Abraham and in the house of Imran over the world.
34 also.
And offspring of one another.
Yes.
And Allah is ever heard.
So whatever Quran is talking about Adam timeline history, Noah timeline history, family of Imran timeline history, Imran timeline. Very few ayahs deals with Prophet Muhammad. You're getting the point.
So
Quran is basically a time travel book.
Okay.
So that Prophet Muhammad is all a reminder, and there are the two sections: people of the book. The first people who got the book is Shiva, and his colonies are known as people of the book. And when at the same time, the people of the book has a wider meaning. Even children of Israel are also included. But when the Quran is talking children of Israel, it's only referring to children of Israel. Roman Empire, Persian Empire, Prophet Muhammad never entertained them. Jesus never entertained them. And that's the reason why these people are heedless people. And among the bloodline of Cain, the Christian world would accept Shiva or spiritual part. Whereas the Muslim world, the Shia, the Sufi, the Sunni, Wahhabi, they will reject Shiva and the spiritual part, God-guided part. So basically the Muslim world are the Antichrist, they have been prophesied by every prophet. Because Antichrist means, the first Antichrist is Cain. Coming of Antichrist refers to bloodline of Cain coming to Pandyan colonies. So the settlers from Turkey to India, the white people are basically Antichrist, the bloodline of Cain, and their policy is basically anti to Asivagam. So it's quite natural. Some people rule by arms and ammunition, some people rule by policy. Okay, so the invaders on Pandyan colony is ruling this land with anti-policy, which is anti to God-guided part. So it becomes anti-spiritual. So Muslim world will never accept spiritual part because they are the anti-spiritual people.
For example, I'm a Muslim.
Yeah.
I'm offering my prayers and I'm at peace.
See, now, namaz which we are doing, it's not the namaz. It's a copy from Zoroastrianism. The Miraj is already also a fake hadith, because
what is the criteria for which you would say we want peace, to have peace?
See, the thing is, let me tell you one thing. First of all, let's see whether you are a believer or not. How to find whether I am a believer or not? Individual, let's examine ourselves. Chapter 4, verse 136. Open it.
Chapter 4, 136. Okay. You have believed in Allah and His Messenger and the book which He has been sending down on His Messenger and the book which He sent down earlier. And whosoever disbelieves in Allah and His angels and His books and His messengers and the last day, he has already erred into fat error.
Last day. So believe in Allah, believe in angels, believe in books, believe in messenger, believe in last day. These are the five test paper which one has to be believed. And Quran is a book of Iman, so it explaining all these five books of thing. Now open chapter 2, verse 8.
Okay. And of mankind are some who say we have believed in Allah in the last day, and in no way they are believers. Okay.
So the people who talks about God and the last day, Allah is clearly saying they are not believers. You look into every religion, they will talk about God and the last day, whether it be Christianity, whether it be Shia, Sufi, Sunni, Wahhabi, everyone is talking about Allah and the last day. But if you want to be a believer, you have to talk about history part also. That is all book, all messenger. All book, all messenger belongs to Adam, Noah, family of Imran, family of Abraham. From there, we have two tribes, people of the book and children of Israel. So you are hiding the two parts. So when you look into the Hindu thing, he believes in God, he believes in all messengers, all prophets, he believes in angels, and he believes in the last day. So Hindu believes in all five articles of faith and practically living by it. Whereas a Muslim, he only talks about God and the last day. So is Jesus with the Christian organization also doing the same thing. And they leave about, and today like you must have heard of PJ who said that angel, the Harut Marut are not angels but devil. So PJ has, he's taken the, contract to destroy the faith of his followers by destroying angel and saying Harut Marut as devil. When Quran says they are angels. So this is the thing. But majority of the people are not talking about history. So they are not believers. 60% of the Quran is just history, talking about Adam, Noah, family of Imran, family of Ibrahim, and nobody is talking about. And every what history the Muslims are talking about is after Prophet Muhammad, after 200 years, where Bukhari wrote hadith and all, and they are talking about that. So it's basically they are outside the fold of Islam. And Allah may forgive Hindus and Christians and other people, but since Muslims are coming under the Munafiq category, they will be in the lowest depth of hellfire because they have the book and they are not they think we are living a superiority complex that we are Muslim, we are going to heaven, rest are all kafir.
So you are saying like you have something, but once you put your time and energy into it, then it will work. Otherwise, it will not work. But those who have not got that specific, let's say, instrument, they are not questioned for it.
No. See, that right now the Quran is in your house, my house, every Muslim house, Quran has. Quran, and Quran is a book of peace, and Quran is the only solution for mankind. Today, if you see the Muslim world, in the name of Prophet Muhammad and Hadith, they are destroying everyone.
Destroying, how is it like?
See, saying? For example, the mode of worship is yoga and meditation. Are we following yoga and meditation? Are we activating Kundalini Chakra? Chapter 15, verse 87. Prophet Muhammad activated Kundalini Chakra. Chapter 15, verse 87. Open it.
And indeed, we have already bought you seven off repeated, as it includes praise and laudish.
Don't read the bracket. It's only.
Yes. And indeed, we have already bought you seven oft repeated, and the magnificent
Quran.
Okay.
The Prophet Muhammad was given two things. One is seven oft repeated, and seven oft repeated is seven chakras, the Kundalini chakras, which can only be activated through yoga and meditation. And Allah gave Prophet Muhammad was Quran, the book of wisdom. Two things has given. Brother.
Okay, now here it says we have already brought to you seven off repeated. What does it
off repeated means? Is the Kundalini circle of Kundalini, the serpent which goes from one Kundalini to another, and this is our seventh Kundalini.
Where is it mentioned? I mean, how do you know that it is
Prophet Muhammad is not following any new thing. He's the follower and he's following the tradition. And we can go through chapter 24, verse 35, which talks about pineal gland, third eye.
Allah is the light of heavens and the earth. The stimulant of his light is as a niche wherein is a lamp. The lamp in a glass, the glass at his getting glittering planet kindled with from a blessed tree, an olive that is neither eastern nor western, whose oil would almost illuminate even if no fire touched it. Light upon light, Allah guides to his light whomever he decides, and Allah strikes stimulatus for mankind, and Allah is ever knowing of everything.
this thing is talking about Kundalini chakra, the spinal gland, which is there between the two hemisphere of brain, the left and the right, the pineal gland. You know where the pineal gland is. So when you do, I have my video on my channel. You know my channel name, no? Asivagam United Under Tamil Shiva.
He performed yoga chakras and he never mentioned anything about it. So how are you so sure that this is something which he performed, and how is it?
Because he is following the way of life which Noah has followed, and Noah followed Shiva, and Shiva gave us he was the first to activate his Kundalini, and he meditation and yoga was given to him, and every prophet did the same.
Okay, but if that is so, why did he never mentioned about it? He mentioned about prayer. He mentioned about doing this and this right thing, this wrong thing, and so many things.
See, chapter two, chapter 2, verse 2 is telling conscious of Allah. How to get conscious of Allah? Chapter 2, verse 2.
That is the book. There is no suspicion about it. A guidance to the pious. Okay.
Yes. And if you go deep into it, you will find the conscious of Allah. How to get conscious of Allah? Through namaz. In 5 minutes you will get conscious of God, because we are not able to focus for 5 minutes. We are thinking about world in the namaz also. So works.
My question is that this is how we should pray, and all these things have been taught and it has been followed, and it can be said like, okay, this has to be done, this is prohibited and all these things, but why is something so important never taught?
See, the thing is, first of all, Prophet Muhammad used to go to cave before getting a revelation. He was visiting cave. What was he doing in the cave? Because his all his ancestors were meditating.
Meditation
is the only way to get conscious with God. There is no other way you can.
My question is, yeah. I understand that.
Yeah.
Everybody has the same process. I mean, more or less the same process. I understand that.
Yeah.
But my question here is that if something is so important, why has it not been or never been taught or asked to perform?
See, Quran is basically not a book of, it's a reminder. You're getting the point. It's a reminder. The thing is, namaz came after Prophet Muhammad. There was no such thing as the namaz before it. And those Persians were sitting in front of fire, and they used to do that. The Zoroastrianism, they worship fire. And they used to go to five time in their fire temple. Okay, so and namaz was introduced only by Bukhari. That came after 200 years, Burak hadith. The big namaz, big asanas, was shortened and reduced to five time namaz, which currently people are doing.
But what if that is enough?
But that hadith is fake. The five time namaz where they are saying that Prophet Muhammad went to for Miraj. There is no such thing as Miraj in the Quran. You can only find chapter 17 verse 1. Read it for travel to and what really happened during the travel. That was the mention in Quran.
17?
Chapter verse 1.
extolment be who made his bondman to set forth by night from the immobile mosque to the further mosque around which we have blessed, that we might know him of our signs. Surely he is the ever hearing, ever beholding.
Yeah. So Prophet Muhammad started his journey, Isra. Miraj is fake. Isra is correct. Isra is a travel from Mecca to Jerusalem and its adjoining area. So adjoining area, you can say that wherever Ibrahim travels, so that can be included in that. But this is what, the greater Israel, people are talking about greater Israel. So we can say that Prophet Muhammad was shown his ancestral property, because he's from the lineage of Ibrahim. Ibrahim.
No, you're saying that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam never insisted on praying five times a day.
No, the thing is, the five times prayer was introduced after 200 years by Bukhari. and that is copied from Zoroastrianism. My thing is, first of all, and they insert this Burak Hadith. Burak Hadith, which they say Prophet went to Jerusalem and then the Burak took him to heaven. But the heaven part is missing na, in Quran. So where is the question?
No, I don't know that.
There are two things. Isra and Miraj. There are two things they talk about. Isra is in Quran. Miraj is copied from Zoroastrianism.
Okay. So, okay. Now, I was told that you're not supposed to fast on Saturday because you have to be an individual. You always, Allah loves who? Loves the most who is... individual of his own kind. I mean, being of his own kind, being unique is something which Allah loves. So that's what I read.
So this is in Hadith or Quran? This is in Hadith or Quran?
I don't remember. So surely Allah loves the one who is, who is unique in his own style.
See, the thing is, Allah guides whom He will. So He doesn't want so to get to that right part, you have to work hard.
What I was asking was my question was entirely different. It was that Saturday you are not supposed to fast for one day because there is a Jewish people, I think they fast on Saturday. So do not fast only on Saturday.
Jewish
either
Jewish people. Who are the Jewish people? First, tell me who's the Jewish people?
Zionist?
Jewish people? Let's read chapter 2, verse 140. Jewish people have nothing to do with Torah or Injil or Quran.
Or even do you say that Ibrahim and Ishmael, okay. And Ishak and Jacob and his grandsons.
And his 12 tribe, yeah.
Zodiac.
Was Jews.
Okay.
So,
Zodiac.
Yeah, Christian.
Christian. Okay. Yeah. Say, do you know best or Allah?
So,
and who is more unjust than he who has kept back in his presence a testimony from Allah? And in no way is Allah ever heedless of whatever you do.
So Torah and Gospel has got nothing to do with Jewish. So, so who are the Jewish people? I am asking you a question because Quran has denied them.
I have repeatedly also heard in mosque that you are not supposed to
see mosque
is
a house of devil. So whatever they are talking Zoroastrianism or Persian doctrine. Quran doesn't say that. Where the Quran is talking talking about Jew and the Christian. Who are the Jews and the Christian? And since this ayat is clearly saying that Isaac is Israel and his children, right? 12 tribe of house of Israel is also included in it. So there is no way that among those 12 tribe, Christian and Judaism came into existence. So Jews and Christians have got nothing to do with Ibrahim, Ismail, Isaac and Yaqub and his descendant. So there is no question these Jews and Christians have some holy book. So why are we talking about Jews and Christians? When they have no book.
I don't know why I am talking about it. I am just talking about what I heard.
I have given you the Quranic verses. It's clearly saying they are not Jews and Christians. So my question to you is...
Let it be XYZ.
Yeah.
I am just saying that you are not supposed to keep fasting on Saturday because XYZ has the tradition of keeping the fast on Saturday. So keep it from Friday or Saturday or Sunday. No. Like that I was told.
No, the thing is...
So my question is that it is very clearly stated that you are supposed to be an individual kind of... being, you have to mark your own, a way of doing things, even individually and as a religion. I'm not able to understand.
The Jewish scriptures or the Persian doctrine or all the invaders, man-made thing, have got nothing to do with the holy book of people of the book and children of Israel. Torah, Gospel and Quran is all interconnected. It's reminding only people of the book and children of Israel. Jews, Christian and Muslim have no right even to touch that book. Because you have read Yasin, where it clearly says that you have been sent to a people whose forefathers were not warned. Warn them or do not warn them, they will not believe. So Prophet Muhammad never entertained them. And who are the Jews and Christians? As per the Bukhari Hadith, they are the Persian and the Romans.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, my question to you is very direct and simple.
Yeah.
Does Prophet Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam tells you to asks you to perform prayers in mosque, because when he came from Mecca to Medina again, he built a mosque and the prayer was happening. So I don't understand at all.
See, the thing is, old Qibla. I'll come to that one. Old Qibla means, what do you understand by old Qibla? And what do you understand by the new Qibla?
I heard about it. I'm not sure. Please go ahead.
See, old Qibla means like how we say Koel, K-O-I-L. Koel means house of administration. So old Qibla or old administration center belongs to whom? Children of Israel. It was built by King Solomon, right? At Jerusalem. When Prophet Muhammad came, for them, right to administration among the family of Ibrahim to become Khalifa is with the tribe Judah, Moors. That's the reason why Moors ruled 800 years in Spain, Europe. Who ruled 800 years? The Moors, M-O-O-R-S, Moors. And these people, when the new Qibla was appointed at Mecca, because Prophet Muhammad clearly said that we don't have to fight for the old Qibla, we leave it, this is a new administration center. Because Allah's script is already there. So when you read chapter 17, verse 104, that is the time when children of Israel will take over their old Qibla, that is Jerusalem. You can read chapter 17, verse 104. So nowhere Prophet Muhammad wanted Jerusalem that time. And now any of his Sahabi went and they captured Jerusalem. So this, or whatever you are reading, that Umar went and got the key of Baitul Muqaddas, it's all fake story. So when the Jerusalem will only come to the children of Israel as per the Quran. And also, you can read chapter 17, verse 104.
Sorry, your voice was breaking up, so I just went out and I didn't hear.
Okay, chapter 17, verse 104.
17 104.
What did you missed actually?
I was long gone, I guess. 104.
Yeah, 104.
Okay.
You were talking about the old Qibla and new Qibla.
Yeah, old Qibla. Yes. Yeah. Yes. You have believed not say Raina and.
Chapter 17:17:17:104.
And we said to seeds of after him dwell in the land, and then we promise of thereafter comes, we will cause you to come clustering.
Yeah. So the old Qibla, that is Jerusalem. So Jerusalem, it was the old Qibla of children of Israel. And Prophet, during Prophet Muhammad's time, their new administration was Mecca. And from Mecca, they ruled Spain for 800 years. So this is what that's the reason for change of Qibla. There is no need for bowing down towards it. So that's a different issue. But the thing is,
it's for direction, right?
No, it's a administration. It's a direction also, where the Khalifa among the family of.
Okay, my basic question is that whether to pray. What did Muhammad Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam say? You should be performing prayers or not? That's what I'm asking.
Pray is something very individual. How your relationship is with your God is between you and God.
Okay, but he performed five times prayer in repeated multiple hadiths. It has been mentioned.
Hadith, and, the hadith is fake. Whichever.
Okay, even if one or two is wrong, you can say something like that. But with witness, there are like hundreds of hadiths saying that he performed this prayer.
Okay, I agree with you. But performing, let's accept that namaz is there. Behind whom? Behind whom?
Behind the imam.
Who's the imam? A pujari or a khalifa?
Okay, let's say, no, I see. When Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was there, he performed, that does not mean indirectly that nobody else should be the imam, right?
No. The imam is very clear. You can read chapter 3, verse 144. You will come to know 3, verse 144.
144. And in no way is Muhammad except a messenger. Messengers have already passed away before him. And will it be that in case he dies or is killed, will you turn on his heels? Then he will never harm Allah in anything, and Allah will recompense the thankful.
What have you understand this ayat?
In no way except the messenger already passed. Okay, he is just a messenger.
And what is the role?
He is a messenger, and if he dies, or then will.
Who's you? You is someone different. Who you refers to the person who is into administration rank, and Prophet Muhammad rank is a messenger, and many messengers have come and gone. So what is the role of a messenger? Swiggy, Zomato, they are also messengers, no?
Yeah.
Their work is to take the goods from a concerned person
no,
and deliver, deliver
no,
it.
Let me ask you.
Yeah.
No. I just want a straightforward answer.
Yeah.
So I'm just asking you a very straightforward question.
I've given you the verse, na? You said imam.
No, but you did not say yes. You did not say yes or no. You said let's consider it yes as a yes.
What is the imam means leader. Prophet Muhammad is not a leader. He is a messenger, and his work is to remind, rectify previous book, and remind the previous the people of the book and children
okay,
of Israel.
Even if in that case,
yeah.
Whom do you think? Okay, let you tell me. No, what do you think about prayer, and what are the formalities? Should not time or whatever you
see
know
the
about
pur-
it.
See the purpose is as per the scientific terms. We have to give ourselves 40 minutes exercise, whether it be morning, evening, whatever time suitable for you. Give 40 minutes
okay.
So you can have a healthy body. And meditation is usually done early morning or late night. So meditation is we can be done at night time, and exercise you have to give almost like 30 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes, whatever you do to healthy body, healthy mind is the concept
okay.
of Islam. So yoga and meditation.
Okay.
Yoga means any exercise. And Friday is a day where you get behind the appointed Khalifa, not the Pujari.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's what Sangam era is all about. Pandian Sangam, the Tamil Sangam, they talk about. What does Sangam mean? Sangam means a get together. Behind whom? Behind the Khalifa, the vicegerent, successful authority. So people, all the rank, Shobha, their chief used to be present on the parliament. So Koil means house of a king. So that's what Jumma is all about. Behind the administrator, not behind the Pujari.
Okay, so you are saying that Imam should not perform the prayer, instead
see, they are Pujari, they are not Imam. See, Imam means leader. Who has a...
They are Pujari. Okay, then who is a leader?
Muslim, their leaders are the four beasts, the Roman, the Persian, the Saudis, they are the...
Where would I search a Roman in Madurai?
No, the thing is, right now, under the Muslim label, you will find only beasts, because Bible chapters, Daniel chapter 7 talks about the four beastly regime who will prolong the Kali Yuga. Okay, so Antichrist policy. So whole Muslimdom is in living under the anti-spiritual policy. So nowhere your namaz or your system is Islamic. Even your Bakri is un-Islamic. It has got nothing to do with Quran. So namaz, Bakri,
okay.
circumcision,
see,
even circumcision is
okay.
anti-spiritual. So you are talking about namaz.
Okay,
namaz,
but,
namaz is behind, even if we have when the call of Jumma, means call of a Jumma means when the administrator calls you, right, leave your trade and get to the koil or the administrator. Because you may lose something. Because
okay.
if suppose a administrator makes certain rules and regulation, and your tribe, your shuba, your department doesn't benefit from his policy, who will be the loser? So leave the job and attend the get together. That is a day of congregation behind the rulers. Prolonging due to four beastly regime disguised as Muslim world. Satyugam possible only through straight part of first Siddha Tamil Shiva. Nandri Vanakkam.